That's the only thing that I was rehearsing since I've got the invitation of coming up and speaking up over here. From 2 weeks, the only thing I was planning was good afternoon, sir. And when I walked in here, everyone told me that you have to speak in the morning. I was like, no, I was rehearsing for good afternoon, sir. Not good afternoon, not good morning, not good evening. So good, we are on time. So good afternoon to all. Just to add to what ma'am just told about me was, I used to be a swimmer till September of last year. And then I decided to change my profession from swimming to coaching. So I believe that whatever knowledge that I have gathered for over past 20-25 years of swimming, it's time for me to give it back to the society and spread the knowledge to the small kids who don't have that much of financial background to travel across the world and gather that knowledge. So my story is actually, there are two different stories. First one is the struggle, and the second one is the hard work. So the struggle part of the story is basically what my mother has done for me, and the hard work is what I have done. So combine those two stories and I am the end product of those two stories. So the struggle that we have been through, I'm just going to take you through, try not to be too long, but I'll try to take you through what I have been through in my life, what my mother has been through in her life. So my father passed away when I was 2 years old, and me and my sister used to, you know, fight a lot, which usually siblings do. So my mother decided to put both of us into swimming camps so that we have less time fighting. And surprisingly, both of us wanted to be better than each other. So we had that competitive spirit going on from the start. So when we started off, we were living in a joint family, but after my father passed away, my mother took a very hard decision of splitting up from the family and surviving on her own. So me and my mother and my sister, we, three of us, we used to live in one room. We had a big house, but then since we got separated, then everybody else got separated. So we started living in one house. In one room, we had one double bed, the king size bed. We had small kitchen in that same room, and the room was about 12 feet by 12 feet. So that's where we started off with. And now that there was no family income coming in, my mother decided to keep, at that time, two buffaloes. And she started selling the milk that the buffaloes were producing. And that was our family income. Family income for me, my sister and my mother to survive. And then she decided to add a little more expense on her head by putting both of us to swimming classes. But we were lucky enough to have a government school right next to us where 300 rupees a month was the swimming lessons for one. So that was 600 rupees of added expense, which we were very scared of. Actually, my mother was. We didn't realize that at that time. So what we used to commute by buses every morning. So we used to train at 5 o'clock, get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, reach the swimming pool by 5:30, finish our workout till around 7 o'clock. From there, come back to the house, then go to the school, again come back in the afternoon, run to the swimming pool again, do our evening sessions, come back home, do our homework and sleep. All this while, we were getting up at 5 o'clock. My mother was getting up at 3 o'clock. So at that, from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock, she made sure that me and my sister do not miss a meal, and that she fed the buffaloes. She milked the buffaloes before we left. She gave the milk to my grandmother for her to distribute it amongst whoever is willing to purchase it. And at the end of the month, everyone would give the money, and that's how we would survive. So when we used to use public transport, for me and my sister, it was so much fun. But for my mother, it was a struggle because she had to buy 3 tickets. And because we were doing it for so long, after 2 years, the bus drivers and the conductors, they knew us very well. because we were the first one to take that 5 o'clock bus. That was the first bus that left from Maroli, which took us to the swimming pool. So from there onwards, from our house till the swimming pool, the cost was 3 rupees for the ticket, for one ticket. So she used to buy 2 half tickets and 1 full ticket for herself. Just to save 1 rupees, we used to go 5 minutes early, and my mother used to motivate me and my sister to run from one bus stop to the another bus stop, and she would carry our bags and wait for the bus, save 1 buck, and then we used to be very proud of ourselves. Now, that time we didn't realize, me and my sister did not realize that this was actually the struggle period that we were going through. For us, it was, oh, we get to run on the road. It's fun, let's do it. So me and my sister used to run. Then small things started building up. Then me and my sister started building up interest in swimming. So after 2 years, we started competing at state level. My sister started competing at national level. I was still at state level. So she used to go on trips where Delhi government paid for the travel and stay and everything. And I used to be sitting at home, and because my sister was going, my mother couldn't leave my sister alone. So she used to go along with my sister. So I used to stay at Nani's house for one week till she returns, and then the whole thing again starts. And then, you know, like that we survived for almost 4 to 5 years. So from there onwards, after we reached a state level and national level, when me and my sister both crossed around, were in 10th or 12th, I was in 10th, my sister was in 12th, that was the time we realized that what we were been doing for fun was actually the struggle part. And that our mother had sacrificed so much for us that we need to start working hard in order to make that sacrifice worth it. So what I decided to move from Delhi to Bangalore after my 12th standard, and I trained in Bangalore for 6 years with no off season, with no breaks in between, with not taking a single day off from training. And we used to train for 12 sessions a week. That's from Monday to Saturday, 2 sessions every day. And then we used to get Sunday off to recover. And I used to get up at around 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock in the evening on Sundays, because that's how tired I was from the whole week. So it is very important for, I know the sacrifices, there are people who would make sacrifices, there are people who will try to work around the sacrifices. But for me, that sacrifice helped me realize the importance of my life and the sacrifice that my mother had made. So I didn't want my mother to struggle more. So I and my sister decided to work hard. And then from 2003 was my first national medal. And then Nihar sir, who's running an academy in Bangalore, he spotted me and he wanted me to train with him. So my mother couldn't come with me, obviously, because my sister was at home and she had to take care of my sister, and she had to take care of 2 buffaloes, which she had till almost when we crossed 12th. So she was doing all that. In the meanwhile, I decided to go from Delhi to Bangalore all by myself for the first time in my life. Otherwise, everywhere I traveled, my mother used to travel with me. From that time onwards, from 2004 onwards till 2000, almost till 2008. So that's about, no, from 12th. So 12th, I finished 12th in 2006. From 2006 to 2008, I was in 2008 a national champion for age group of 16 and under. From there, I went to qualify for the Olympics within 2 years, purely on hard work. And every time I used to go to the pool, the only thing that was there in my mind was the sacrifice that my mother has made for me. So these two stories combined. So I think sacrifice, the bigger the sacrifice, the more the value it has. That's what I have learned. And there will be sacrifices, there will be hard work. So as long as you know how to combine both of them, and if you can, it's never too late to start working hard. So if a lot of you might be thinking that, oh, we are already so old, and we have already cleared our 12th, we cannot work hard now, we cannot do this, we cannot do that. Those are all excuses. And the first thing I learned when I went to Bangalore, I raced against one of the swimmers who used to train with us. So just in training for fun, we raced once when sir was not around. So he was from Bangalore. He beat me in the 25 meters of my main stroke, which I was national champion in. I was national champion in 200 meters breaststroke. And that time I told him that I did not get a good start and I touched the bottom, and I actually did. So he told me one thing. He said, losers will always have excuses and winners will always have reasons. From that point onwards, I have never let any excuse come in the way of winning a national medal or winning an Asian Games medal or qualifying for the Olympics. So I have learned so much from that one word, one liner that he told me has changed my life completely. So I hope this story might inspire a lot of you, and hopefully you guys can also do something and inspire more people around you.